Blue Lock is the new trending sport anime that everyone is really enjoying to see, but I think this is because of the approach the sports series is giving. The crazy matches, egotistical personalities, and magical creativity really gives this series an appeal unlike no other. Awakening your ego. It's a no-brainer that Blue Lock is teaching you about awakening your ego. It goes to show you that everyone has ego, but how they use it is completely up to you. Your ego is your sense of self-importance. Everyone has ego, and I think it's important for others to have more ego than others. But it's how that ego translates to yourself is what's really important. There are a bunch of egoists in Blue Lock, but not all of them could live up to what they were talking about and became broken. I think ego becomes an issue only when it's overpowering, meaning your sense of reality is so distorted that you don't even see through your own self anymore. In Blue Lock, others could tell who had the highest self-importance and who didn't. They spotted out weaknesses in everyone and who would lower their guards for certain things. Ego is wanting to prove and to possess. Ego can make you suffer and be in discomfort. Throughout Blue Lock, the players were tested to transcend their egos into higher versions in order to come close to winning the World Cup for Japan. Jinpachi Ego put the players through special training regimes where the players' egos would be tested and also how to combine an ego with another's ego. This led to chemical reactions which would serve as a purpose throughout Blue Lock for scoring goals without the main use of teamwork. In Blue Lock, only the self-highly acclaimed individuals would be successful in the long run. The very essence of Blue Lock is to create one true striker who will lead Japan to victory in the World Cup, to throw away all common sense and become a protagonist with everyone else in the field being support characters for you, constantly being thrown as the best and beating strong opponents next to you. Your ego is bound to go even higher and higher. Blue Lock was like a battlefield where you're always fighting in life or death situations of your ego. Whoever's ego shined the brightest would be the one in the center of attention and looked at the most. It was the individuality play styles of everyone that allowed their Blue Lock style of play to work in other spots. The clash of egos was evident everywhere in Blue Lock, and this challenge to help everyone understand themselves even more and put themselves in positions where they would best excel at. The character development of each character is so good because of this reasoning of egos always combating against one another. Blue Lock is always talking about becoming a protagonist and seeing everyone around you as a supporting character. This is how you see your life and realize all of the smaller things do not matter. I think my ego personally has increased just from reading Blue Lock because of a lot of the points made in Blue Lock can be used in real life. Becoming aware of your weapons. Understanding your weapons and how to use them was also a center focus in Blue Lock. Everyone had to figure out what their weapon was and how to maximize it and then come up with unique ways to use it. Then when they had their weapons, they also needed to learn how to combine their weapons with someone else and create a chemical reaction. This can be useful in real life because we all have a gift or weapon in our lives and we just need to first find out what our weapon is and then how to make it useful in our lives and how to combine it with someone else's. Weapons were a signature thing in Blue Lock, and that is what made the player's character development so unique. Blue Lock is teaching the way weapons are used and the creativity through the weapons of the player's personality. Becoming aware of your weapon is something we all can understand more, and Blue Lock is definitely teaching that throughout the series. The different play styles and ways to score a goal are always so different that Blue Lock's style of play can be very chaotic and cause confusion into other systems' style of play. The ego of everyone allowed these weapons to blow out of proportion as well. It becomes something that no one could really develop without being in a Blue Lock system. Environment. I think environment is another thing that Blue Lock is also teaching. The environment of Blue Lock is what allows such fast progression towards excellence and becoming a great player. The ecosystem and constant training of Blue Lock is what catered to the success. The constant battlefield-like environment where egos constantly clash was a result of the constant self-developmental process in Blue Lock. The series really teaches you how your environment can change who you are. There were many great players in Blue Lock before Blue Lock was a thing, but the environment of Blue Lock really showed everyone's sustainability and potential. This goes to show how an environment that you have never been in can become a transitional period where uncomfortability will test you and change yourself. The environment of Blue Lock completely changed everyone in Blue Lock. What will a new environment change for you? These are the biggest questions we do not want to answer for ourselves, but it can go a long way depending on who you are. Imagine if a Blue Lock style system wasn't just in Japan for these guys, and will we just have egotistical players everywhere just looking to become a striker? Even now in the latest chapters, all the Blue Lock players are currently in different environments to see if they can progress even further without Blue Lock now. To rise to greater heights, Ego Jinpachi now is throwing the Blue Lock players into an even tougher environment in other countries to develop them even further. The new environments are spots for the players to sharpen themselves. For some of the leagues, the Blue Lock players will adapt in that team's environment, but for other teams, the Blue Lock philosophy style environment might make its way onto the team. These are all the factors that I think Blue Lock is teaching, and I think that they can definitely be incorporated into real life. Thank you guys for watching this video. I appreciate it. Please like, subscribe, and I will be back next time for another video. Peace.